Looks good, right? This project was nothing but a roller coaster ride for me. There were so many ups and downs, but I hope you all can enjoy the video. So, enjoy the demo. In this video, I'm going to show you the full installation process of Hyprland on Debian 12 Linux. So, let's get started. What is up, everybody? It's time for another episode of Sam Arcade. To clone or download the repo, just type gitlab space samarcade space hyper-debian. This is my gitlab repo for hyper-debian. It contains all the necessary information as well as the instructions for the installation. Now log in with your username and password. My Debian 12's kernel version is 6.1.0. Type su to login. Now type apt install sudo space git. It is time to add our user to the sudoers list. Type sudo space nano space slash etc slash sudoers. Now add your user inside the user privilege section. Now we are going to edit our sources.list file. Type sudo space nano space slash etc slash apt slash sources.list. Just change http to https and add contrib space non-free at the end of the sources. Type contrib space non-free. Then hit Ctrl plus K. And to paste, use Ctrl plus U. Now type sudo apt update. To clone my GitLab repo, type git clone https colon double slash gitlab.com slash samarcade777 slash hyper dash debian.git. Wait for it to download. Now change the directory to the hyper-debian folder. Again, change the directory to the hyperland underscore base folder. Now run the hyperland-install.sh script without root. Only give sudo permission when asked. Now change the directory to the hyperland underscore tools folder. run the tools _.sh script without root. Now, if you guys are new to my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like my video and press the bell icon. Change the directory to the hyprland_config. Now type fonts_download.sh to download the nerd fonts. Now you have to run the fonts_install.sh script twice to make sure that our fonts get installed properly. Run the config_install.sh script to install the config files. Last but not the least, type sudo reboot to reboot the system. As you can see, SDDM and Hyprland both have been installed properly. To check, simply log in. For wallpapers, we are using swww. To change the wallpaper, simply click on the wallpaper button. To activate sway lock effects, simply double click on the lock button. To change brightness, just scroll up and down. Battery and calendar both are working fine. Click on the power button to activate W logout. As you can see, W logout is also working fine. For network management, we are using NMTUI and speedometer. To see network speed, simply edit the speed.sh config file. Now add your Wi-Fi or LAN to see the speed as I am showing in this video. Simply right click on the network icon to launch the speedometer to see your Wi-Fi speed. Right click on the speaker icon to launch the PavView control to see if your audio is working properly or not. Click on the CPU load button to launch the HTOP. The Debian icon will launch the Ranger CLI file manager. Super plus R will launch the puzzle, and to close it, use Control plus R. Let's NeoFetch to see our system configuration. Let's test if Kava is working or not. Workspaces are now working properly. To take a screenshot, use Super plus Alt plus Space. That's it for today's video. If you want to see more videos like this, then make sure to hit like button and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so you never miss out my latest video. And if you have any kind of feedback or suggestion, then feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching.